The Cochise County and Borderlands chapter of the Arizona Master Naturalist Program is a volunteer and leadership program focused on natural resource conservation.
The twin spot rattlesnake, which is on the very top of the mountain, it can't go any higher.
When you participate in the program, not only do you receive environmental-related training, but you also build partnerships that get you connected to natural and cultural resource conservation projects and programs that benefit the environment and our communities in southeastern Arizona. The program is sponsored by the Bisbee Science Exploration and Research Center, which is a 501c3 nonprofit dedicated to informal science, technology, engineering, arts, and mathematics education in rural Arizona. This chapter is approved and certified through the statewide Arizona Master Naturalist Program.
About a couple of years ago, Trevor saw the Master Naturalist programs that were available in the rest of Arizona, but there wasn't one available in southeastern Arizona, which is a shame. We started talking about what it would look like, and we just got a group together that was dedicated and interested and started planning.
You know, I have a background in wildlife and conservation, but all of that came from the East Coast, and when I moved to Arizona, I felt like I had this gap in my knowledge and understanding of, you know, all the flora and fauna here, and I really wanted to fill in that gap and learn more about what we have to offer here. But we did see that there was a Master Naturalist program out of Pima County, and we said, well, if they did that, maybe we could do that. So we reached out to Lorianne from the state, and you know, things just kind of snowballed from there.
And here we are.
The Southeastern Arizona Bird Observatory, SABO, also sponsored this program. SABO is a nonprofit dedicated to the conservation of the birds of southeastern Arizona and their critical habitats. Tom Wood, a naturalist, hummingbird expert, and one of the founders of SABO, was intimately involved in coordinating, facilitating, and teaching this Master Naturalist course. The training to become a Master Naturalist consists of 60 hours of classroom learning taught by local experts.
We're in the heart of the Chiricahua Apache territory. They call themselves Chaconan.
Various group projects to build knowledge and presentation skills, 6 to 10 field trips, and, to start, at least 20 hours of volunteer work. Classroom learning includes geography, geology, hydrology, the plants and animals of our region, including invasive species, phenology, climate change, human history, and land use.
Going back as far as some sources I've read say 11,000 years, some say 13,000 years, regardless, that's a long time ago, right? We've got those Clovis sites.
This is a great program to participate in if you're interested in being an active volunteer and leader, helping community organizations with projects that enhance our environment.
Got an invitation, actually, through the Sky Island Alliance. I get their monthly newsletter, and was very pleased to see them promoting Master Naturalist Program. I've been in the community for about 3 years and was really excited to be part of a program that I'd learn a lot more about the ecology of the Sky Islands region. So that was the impetus for me to join the program.
Well, I liked the hydrology field trip. I thought the hydrology one was really interesting because it just looked like a barren field out in the middle of the desert, and I didn't really realize like how involved the county was with water collection and retainment for recharging the aquifers, and how, you know, you walk by something that seems like this completely random plot and it's actually this really productive research facility that they're doing really interesting things with.
Really, we had two units that were really particularly applicable for me. One was the program development module, and then the other was the one on interpretation programs, where we learned to develop ideas and concepts that we're able to then transfer to visitors. The big takeaways for me are that there are a lot of challenges, but also a lot of opportunities. And I think those opportunities begin with helping people understand what a treasure we have here in the Sky Islands. To have that kind of information in my pocket, to be able to share with others and maybe help them gain some of the enthusiasm I have.
So So we have like a little homestead that we live on, and so we've been learning a lot more about the plants that are there, and because of this program I've learned a lot about invasive species, and so there's some greater reclaim projects that I'm looking to do. And I've always wanted to volunteer, but I've never really known the right outlet to do those things, and so taking the course has given me some resources to kind of jump into the community, like knowing about the science lab or knowing about these different organizations, whereas before, just as a regular citizen, I really did not know. I didn't even know where to start.
If you also want to learn where to start, information about the next course will be posted on this website.